Triple D. It stands for Drive Thousand Architect. We are an automotive startup. We are an automotive startup looking to reduce the number of accidents that happens in long distance, long distance way that people drive. Our team vision is, as I'll say, we aim to save lives on roads. My team consists of five persons. We two are business and three are tech. So we identify that there are 25% of the accidents that happen yearly are happens due to sleepiness of people, of drivers, especially of long distance drivers. And we also see that there is a lot of damage of business, loss of business value. We are talking about billions because customers, companies are losing a lot of money for equity, image, and so on. And we also saw that there are some trends, including Internet of Things, biosensors, and big data that can help us to solve this problem. So according to we believe that a car is a place that people spend a lot of time, and we can gain a lot of information, and we want to use this opportunity for people to spend more than 5 hours daily to collect their biological record. So we have maybe two problems. First, for companies, and this includes insurance companies and commercial companies, logistics companies. The first problem was to ensure safety. Companies want to ensure safety for their employees. The second one was brand image. Companies also want to keep a good image for their company. And the last one is cost saving, so that these companies don't lose money and don't wait for to get money from insurance company and all this stuff. Our customers will be logistics, including Post, the American Post or DHL, but also buses who travel different cities. So now we have here the users. The users are, as you can see, people who drive long and they get also fat. They are not aware about the consequences of traveling and not doing work. And the second segment will be bus drivers. Bus have the problem of getting tired and driving while they are tired. So we want to first solve this problem of being tired and driving when they are tired. We want to announce these people that they are getting tired, maybe to offer them to go to drink a coffee or to use some tools to aware these people. And life rescue, so we want also to identify some symptoms that tell us that there are that the people, the drivers are getting to be tired, and also in the worst case, they can also press on a button and they can be rescued by ATSC or something. And finally, we have also the track your heart behavioral. So there are today many providers in the market who are offering telemedicine. And we want to use this data to work together with telemedicine segment. To work with this segment in order to track the people. And our product consists of emergency services and healthcare services, as I said, and my colleague will show you now the product.
Okay. The product is composed by two components, actually three components. The steering wheel cover that you put around the steering wheel, and then it has the sensor that gets your vital signals and transmit them to a monitor station that show visually to the user, to the driver, the status of that his body and the status of the cabin and the environment in the cabin, because we have in this monitor station that we can see from prototype here. Gas sensor stations that can take oxygen and CO2 and the temperature humidity, and then 2 RGB LEDs, one for the one to show the environmental condition after all data mining of this data that are collected, and one to show the driver status based on the vital signals that were collected with the sensor on the steering wheel. If a critical condition comes, the alarm starts ringing, and in the worst case scenario, pressing a button, the emergency can come to save you.
Alright, cool. Thank you very much.
We had also a prototype actually that is working, and it simulates the heart rate trend and the temperature trend, and trigger the various alarms and everything. But yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much. Questions from your side?
Yeah. How sure are you that you can detect sleep with just
sleep? We will observe the driver's heart rate, and we see the trend. If if the driver is driving in a straightforward way the whole time, and we will use the noise sensor to see that nobody is sitting there, and we detect like a trend decreasing heart rate, so we can ask or we can derive from this that he is getting relaxed. And we will also use some data mining between, so for example, if he went to eat something and he came afterwards, the risk is higher. And then we will include a button like in the Deutsche Bahn, and you will ask him, for example, and see the reaction time. But we are not going to ask every 5 minutes like what the Deutsche Bahn is doing, because it's annoying. We will ask these questions only in case we see there is a trend of decreasing heart rate.
And how does the alarm look like? Is it like a button or like a sound?
It could be like a button which say, please click here. And if you don't click within at least 5 seconds, so you are not aware or your concentration is lower.
I serious doubt that this will really detect the sleep. But if I don't think customers want this. I don't think that I want this in my car.
We don't believe that single customers will buy it. We believe that insurance company will pay for this, because they are interested to pay less for losses for a company. So they will be our customers, and maybe they will enforce or they will force people to use it.
For example, if you consider trucks and buses that don't embed the new technology, the newest technology, so they don't have a computer on board. And everything, there is no intelligence on that. This is a way to actually make these old, these traditional cars and trucks, buses, smart and more safe.
But you are talking about heart rate, not ECG. ECG is more accurate and can detect this kind of trends. Okay. And our product is not heart rate. Here we did it with heart rate because
it
don't have ECG.
It's more than heart rate.
Yeah, ECG.
And not medicine.
Okay, no, ECG is more precise. And there are some companies who are also integrating ECG in the seat. So in the future, we will also cooperate and work together. We'll not need to integrate it in the system. Yes?
Have you talked to an insurance company? So
no, we didn't do it because today is Saturday. We'll do it during the next week, and thanks for the contact. Yes?
And you have been talking about truck driver strikes?
Today, we didn't get it because we were working on
Okay, so that I think really needs to be done. My feedback to your presentation again, because I was under the same confusion as you know. Be clear about your customer segments. As you saw, I was not the only one who thought you might cater to the end consumer. So be more precise about this. And I have a question, and it might be that you only can answer that after you've really contacted truck drivers and saw how these cabins look like. Because so far, if you painted this steering wheel cover, you said, okay, it will have multiple sensors in there. My question is, does it really need many sensors?
No,
or is there maybe a hand position that is usually up here to your hands and up here or something that you only can have?
That limits the driver like to catch it from here or from here. So basically, you want something that to be...
Yeah, but I think you can just easily check that with truck drivers if it is not their favorite hand position anyway, because if the sensors might not have to be in the whole cover, then don't. That saves money.
We were thinking about a cover around the whole steering wheel because this is the first prototype and it's based on what we thought that it could be useful. But of course, we'll interview the people that actually drive every day for a long time in order to figure out that. And also in order to keep the number of sensors inside the cover as less as possible, because it means a power consumption and it means increased cost.
But I think that you also underestimate telemedicine, because it is today, nowadays, it's very important in the big market, and if we'll be able to deliver the hardware and ECG to these companies, we can cooperate and provide good information. So, thank you very much.
Thank you.